Toyota Yaris EA, Mazda CX-3 sales show crossover formula isn't an automatic win. While 2017 was another watershed year for crossovers, in one interesting case, a crossover had its lunch eaten by its sedan counterpart. In the past year, Toyota sold nearly 36,000 Yaris EAs, a sedan that is identical to the foreign market Mazda 2 in everything but Toyota's ugly front bumper. In the same time frame, Mazda sold just over 16,000 CX-3s, a subcompact crossover based on the Mazda 2. Not only that, but the Yaris EA saw an increase of around 8,000 units over 2016, and the CX-3 sold about 2,000 fewer units than in 2016. There are a few reasons this is surprising. First, of course, is that the crossover market is surface of the sun hot right now, so much so that primarily crossover building brand Subaru saw its best sales year ever last year. Even Mazda's other crossovers, the CX-5 and CX-9, saw better sales in 2017 than in 2016. But on paper, the CX-3 has a number of advantages compared to the Yaris EA. The CX-3 has a larger 2.0-liter four-cylinder that makes about 40 more horsepower than the 1.5-liter engine in the Toyota. Also, while the cargo area behind the rear seats in the CX-3 is about 1 cubic foot smaller than the EA, it has the added flexibility of being a hatchback, and thus having more capability when it comes to large, bulky items. And of course, the CX-3 is quite a shapely machine compared with the awkward, angry-looking EA. That's not to say the EA doesn't have any of its own advantages. It gets 3 more mpg in the city and 6 more on the highway than the CX-3. It also costs roughly $3,000 to $4,000 less than a CX-3 and can be found at more dealers than the Mazda. But it's still surprising that a car, especially a sedan, can outsell a mechanically very similar crossover. Apparently, the formula of adding more ground clearance and plastic fenders isn't foolproof. Then again, maybe it's not such a big deal to Mazda, since the CX-3's total sales were just over a tenth that of the Mazda CX-5.